Hello YouTube, and welcome to a new Unity 3D tutorial. And what we're going to do in this space tutorial is we're going to carry on with our AI, but we're going to adapt it slightly. We're going to make it so it looks at us when it's angry, so it's following us with its eyes, so like, I'm going to get you. We're going to make it shoot, so boom, 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 we've already got that script, and we've already got a look at script. But then we're going to implement something new we've not looked at before. And when I tell you where it is, you're going to be like, well, I'll either use it once or twice, but then I'll never use it. It's not very useful. But then when I explain to you in the after what it's for, you'll know that this is going to go big for you. And I've used this quite a lot in my games, and it works really, really well. So it's better for space because you can, but if you adapt it, you can actually make it work in land as well. It is good, but space is just better because it's open. So what we're going to do is make it actually move towards you. And this requires a script which basically pushes him, makes him look at you, and pushes him just forward, so just a bit like add force, but not as bad. Because add force will continue gaining speed as it goes, it won't just stay on one speed. Whereas this will literally push it by each vector at where it's going. Now you think it's not very useful, but then imagine if we set it some targets, so say we've got four targets in the corners, and we say, if it reaches this one, go to this one. So then we've now got waypoints for our character. And then later in the tutorials we're going to introduce raycast to you, which I'll explain later, don't worry about it. But then you like apply that to it as well, and then you can start beginning making AIs randomly walk around the scene. So as you can see now, it's gone from you'll hardly use it to oh my god, I'm going to use it every day kind of thing. So we're going to get straight into it because it's really easy. So the first thing we're going to do is make it shoot if it's angry. So we're going to go to enemy ship and open up AI. Boom. Perfect. So, again, dialogue test is there. I explained it in the last tutorial, but if you weren't there or you don't visit that one, dialogue test is a dialogue scripting thing I'm working on. It'll be the ultimate one. You'll be able to drag as many in and many off as you like. Perfect. Yeah. So, back at here, we need a boolean that basically says, I'm angry. That simple. So, we're going to type private var NPC enemy will be boolean equals false. There we go. So we're going to come down. If its respect is less than 49, then we'll type NPC enemy equals true. So now it's angry at us. But, well, what's the point of that? So we're going to find this one here, what says NPC is talking, and we're going to put and if NPC enemy equals false. So basically, if he's never seen you before, and NPC talking is true, well, false as well. So if he's not seen you and he's not talked to you, he'll talk to you but then make you an enemy because he's an enemy with you. And then otherwise, if you go out of his way, he still remembers your ship, but he will talk to you again. So be like, you're back or something. We'll do that another time, but not now. So we've got that bit going. But what about if you shoot him multiple times? He's going to want to get you. So down here where it says turned aggressive, so he's gone aggressive, we'll just put NPC enemy equals true. So either way, he's going to come out as an enemy if you shoot him or go near an enemy. That simple. So down here, so underneath this move direction and underneath this one, we're going to put if NPC enemy equals true, which it will, we're going to put inside here the code to make him look at you and fire at you. Now we've done this before and it's really simple. So above here, we're going to put the player back to its own variable for the pushing script we're going to need. So I'll just call it player, and we'll go var player will be a vector 3 equals game object transform that position. So player is linked to that. And now in here, we can actually type transform.lookAtPlayer. So now, if he's an enemy with you, he should follow you wherever you dive around. And I've just accidentally clicked on Chrome. So let's see if it works. I've clicked. Okay, so let's go and see him. And you'll see. He's a friend with us, so we shoot him. So we go up to him and we'll shoot him. And you'll see that. So now he's looking directly at us, and as we move, you can see he'll slowly follow us wherever we go, even if we go down. As you can see, he'll follow where we're going now. So He's now staring at us, and now all what's left is to make him go, shoot, 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 and start shooting us. Perfect. So, he looks at us, great. After we've made him shoot us, we'll go and get it. So, in our entity enemy firing, we'll get that. And the reason we're going to use this is purely because we've got it here. We can just copy and paste whatever we need. So, the things we need is definitely this fire option here. And in fact, we all need all of these. So we'll just copy everything. We'll go back to script enemy AI and we'll paste it at the bottom here. So fire and timer need to be their own functions, but we need this one in here. So copy that and bring it up. So in here, if he's an enemy, he's gonna look at us and fire, correct? And below this, we're gonna place this if statement. So basically saying, if a variable called open fire here, paste it here, and we'll make it private as well because we don't need to get it. So if open fire is true, fire. Now by default it'll be true, so as soon as it starts and he's an enemy, he'll fire at us. Then it'll come down to fire, which is here, and it'll say, well, spawn the bullet, correct. Audio.shoot fire, so we need him to fire, and at the spawn point and the fireball. So he's going to shoot using all those variables. So fireball, correct, transform, correct, or fire. Right, we've got all the audio and the spawn point and a fireball. What we're going to do eventually soon is make him randomise between which gun he's firing out of, because then it'll look cooler, but not now. So we'll use all these points to shoot at us here. So he'll fire with the fireball, he'll shoot us with the spawn point, great. And it'll add the force to it, and then play the audio for firing, great. Then it'll turn it to false and activate the timer. The timer will come here if it equals false, which it does. It'll yield to seconds, wait for 2 seconds, then fire again. Boom. 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 Every time he shoots us. And we don't need this one here, so we can go into that. If you haven't got that script, basically all it is creating a Boolean saying if it equals true, by default it does, then spawn a bullet, add a sound to it, just like we've done for our character, but then make that Boolean false at first, and then create another function called timer. The reason we create another one is to add this yield for seconds. You could actually paste it up here, I'm just not going to. In fact, here I am. So I'll paste that there, just save time. There. So it'll make it false, it'll wait for 2 seconds and turn it back to true. It'll come back up, finish, come back up again, it's equals to true, come down, fire again. So it's like a continuous fire sequence. So we can go on, and because that audio was a bit loud, I'm going to make it a minute and in it. So 2. This guy really hates us. So he'll look at us. And as you can see, we haven't assigned any of everything we need. So we need to go in and assign it. So I'll just assign one at random ship spawn points. I'll go to our prefabs and get a fireball. So fireball. We could make him fire swords, but that won't work as well. Not now. So we'll go to our sounds and we'll see what sounds we've got for fireball. We'll just use enemy fireball, that'll work. Is it 3D sound? We'll click apply. This might be very loud, but for those of you that don't know what it is, we used it ages ago in our tutorial, so go back and have a look if you want it. So we'll go up and see him, he'll be friendly, so we make him an enemy. 2, this guy really hates us. Boom. Boom. Just because he's shooting us now. He's trying to kill us. He can't kill us, obviously, because we haven't assigned the fireballs up to what we need. But we can kill him. There. Perfect. So he's dead now. But he kept shooting after he was dead, and you never know, when you kill someone, you might be low on life. So what we need to do is just insert a quick if statement saying if his life's more than normal. So, where do we have our enemy life here? So, if enemy NPC enemy equals true, and enemy life is more than 1, more than 0. Yeah, so if it's more than 0, he'll watch us the next day. Fire, but if it's not, so if he's dead and he's gone he's not going to shoot us again. We don't need to test that though, because it works. So the only thing else left now is to actually make him move. Now, before I carry on, if any of these are wrong, I apologise, but this is what I have been taught about it, and this is the way I learnt it. A lot of people take it differently. If I say the word normalised to you people, the people who've done databases will be like, yep, I know what that is, it's such and so. But when I tell you what it is here, you'll be like, well, no, that's not right. Did mean different things. So in Java, normalized does not always mean the same as what it does here. It's the way they've been interpreted and made. So please don't comment saying you are wrong, you are wrong. Unless in Unity and you think I am generally wrong, please don't comment. People who know me know I'm not a nasty person. I will never ever attack anyone for it. Right, so easiest thing to do is we first need to see when do we want him to follow us. Well, if he's attacking us, he's trying to dogfight us, aka he's following us, correct? So, we'll eventually put I can't remember what word it is. Evasive manoeuvres, is it? Where he'll come up to you, if he gets too close, he'll be like, oh, no, fly away, then come back in and try to get you again. We'll eventually put that stuff in, but not yet. This is just going to be, he's going to come towards you, but if you're far away from him, he'll stop. That simple. So in here, we're going to type the word rigid body. So we're basically, when we go add force, we are basically going into that character and grabbing his rigid body, pulling out and saying, right, I want your force to be whatever we set it to. So transform.forward is your forward z force to 1,000, times it by 1,000, so it'll push it forwards basically. But we're going to edit something called velocity. We will have to stick a rigid body on the character. And what velocity is it will grab the current force, what is placed on all vectors of that rigid body. So vectors, you've got your XYZ vectors, you've got your forward, up, down, left, right vectors. It'll basically put all those to what you want it to be. So if we're going to push it forwards, we put equals, and then we need to get the move direction, because that's pointing it towards us. So basically move direction, point it towards us. That's what that one will do. So we type move direction. But then the weird thing about velocity is that it doesn't work in your force is now 1,000, your force is now 2,000,000. It works in decimals, so 0.1, 0.2, 0.0000, 2 hours later, 0001. It works in decimals, 0.100 to 0.1. I mean 1.0. So we need to somehow make whatever vector we put into it, like that, 0.1. And there's a word what you can use called normalized. Normalized. And what that'll do is turn it to one of those vectors. So it's between 0.0 and 1.0. It'll place it in there at the current whatever you put it at. And all we're going to do is times it by 5. Now this 5 is your speed. So if we go to our ship stats, if you can find it, if I know where it is. Here. Top speed here is 2, will you? So we can set it to that, because that'll work. So if we type instead of 5, we put stats.shipsid.topspeed. And that'll basically push him forward at his speed. We will eventually make him get faster and faster, but not now. Now that is a very weird thing, and I'm not the best at explaining it. But the way I picture it is velocity is the rigid body's force. So we're adding to it and pushing it forwards. So when we're saying change the rigid body's force to the direction, our vector, that's it basically, that's all it is. Our vector times by its speed. So say our vector is 0.1, well, 1, then it'll push it times by our top speed, so 2, 3, so that's its speed. It's weird to get your head around, but if we go and try it once we've assigned a rigid body, you'll see it pushes you forwards. Honestly, I usually copy and paste that line. I could write it off the top of my head every single time, but just work with it and you'll see. So if we go back to enemy ship and add a rigid body, boom, there. Turn gravity off or else your ship will fall and it won't work. And I'm going to make him an enemy. He's been a good guy to us, but we're making him an enemy. 48, just in case. That'll do. So go up to him and he should come straight towards us when he's an enemy. As you can see, he's moving towards us now. And he will never ever stop moving towards us. Even if we shoot him. As you can see, he's going. The reason is because his life equals zero, then he's dead. So the reason it's doing that is if we go up here, enemy life is more than zero, enemy life is more than one. So if it equals zero, he's gonna go. Yeah. So this code was a bit complex to understand at first. I'm sorry I couldn't explain it the best. Some people might be able to. Normalized is different to databases. For you people who are wondering what it means in database, it means something called first normal form, second normal form, third normal form, and it's organizing the data so it's not too like repetitive and everything, making it work. I've studied databases, if anybody didn't know. But that's the code what you need. In a couple of tutorials we will use it for a waypoint script like I've told you, but for now these are the two scripts you want. You could just put literally those two and your move direction and player here on a script, so four lines, and it'll make you follow you all the way around. And yes, before you say, that is also how you make followers, which is another thing we'll do. So I hope you liked it. You can see now he will chase us around the whole map. We will eventually make it so he can't like follow us for infinitely, but for now it's just basic. So it's, come attack us, come on boy, and then he flies away, boom. So it's a cool little effect. For those of you wondering what happens when he gets up close to you, he'll literally just keep pushing into the center of you. Thank you for watching, I hope you liked it. Join my Facebook group. Sorry I couldn't make it the best, but that's the code you need, and see you next time.